Number 9, vacation to Bali, if not Beijing. Number 10, shoes. I'll decide what brand it is. Fine. Yeah. Baby. Hi, my love. One in it. This is the list of all the things that I'd like you to get for me for Valentine's Day. Né? In list of priority. If you can just do about 50% of the things, then we are fine. But, my love, if you can do all 10 of these things, né? I'll fall pregnant and I'll have your baby tomorrow. Tomorrow you'll have a baby. Mwah! I know the vacation to Bali is a bit short notice, but if you do it, I'll have your twins tomorrow. Fall pregnant, birth them, everything, nappies, yours tomorrow. Ta. I'm gonna try, gonna try, gonna try. Work till I die, till I die, till I die. I'm gonna fail and get up, cause I'm not giving up on my dream. Hey gorgeous, and welcome to my channel. I'm Kopano, Shimange, and this is How I Do Things, a show where you send me your questions and I let you know how I would do things, and I can take it as entertainment or use it as advice. Take it, don't take it, use it, don't use it. Listen, there's no pressure at all for you to use what I'm saying, okay? None. None whatsoever. It is your decision. Because me, I'm not professional at all. This is not professional advice at all. I'm just letting you know what I would do if I was in your shoes. So honeys, we are love crazy for the 1st to the 15th of February. Talking about all things love. Dun, 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 dun. And we are having a morning viewing party. So if you want to join the morning party, head over to the comment section down below. You'll see the morning party pinned right at the top. Comment beneath, because I am there from 7:30 to 8:30 live every morning with you, having a chat, causing a storm. It's a party, baby, and bring your friends. All right, so here's the thing. The month of love is driving us all crazy. And the thing is, you are with your man. And now we're talking about money, because it's a Tuesday. So love and money has stages. The same way that when you get into a relationship, that there are different stages of the relationship. There's the part where you guys are flirting, you guys know each other, you like each other, and you start to flirt. And then there's a stage where now you are courting each other, you know, your first date, and it's all good. Then you actually start to get into a relationship, you're dating now, and you're exclusive. And then you get, you know, if it goes further than that, you guys get into a marriage, you're in honeymoon phase, and then you get into the lifelong phase, and then you get old and you die. So there are levels to this relationship thing, clearly. So shouldn't there also be levels to this thing when we're talking about love and money? Makes sense. Today I'm going to tell you the 5 stages of love and money. In terms of how you and your bae talk about money, relate to your money, handle your money as a couple, here are the 5 stages. Let me know in the comment section down below what stage you are on, because it only gets deeper and better the further we go. Stage number 1. Now if you're not dating a broke ass guy, okay, he's not broke, he's not torn and tattered financially, okay? Even if he is, he'll still try to stick to stage number 1, and that is the spoil stage. This is at the beginning of the relationship where the man wants to take you out on dates. He's the one who wants to pay for everything. He's the one who wants to randomly buy you flowers. He randomly wants to buy you shoes. He wants to take you on a vacation. This is the spoil you stage, where the man is very comfortable to pay for everything, or has the desire to pay for everything. Even the broke guys, they feel it in their spirits that they want to pay for everything, but they can't. But they want to. This is the spoil stage, where the woman gets spoiled. Whether you want to be spoiled or you don't want to be spoiled, the man just wants to do it. He just let the man do it, okay? Miss Independent, just let him pay for it. Number 2, I call the popcorn stage, okay? This is where you guys have been dating for a minute, okay? Your dates are getting expensive now. And Miss Independent, you've been suppressing her for far too long. She wants to peep out. So you guys decide you're going to go for dinner. and movies, because you've been dating for a while, so you're gonna go watch a movie and then you're gonna go to dinner, and he agrees to let you buy the popcorn. It's good enough. You can buy the popcorn. He'll pay for the tickets, he'll pay for the dinner, but you want to pay for something, I guess, shop, you can pay for the popcorn. This is the stage where the man still wants to pay for everything and you just want to contribute a little bit, okay? Just a wee bit. Just let me pay for something. And he says, fine, you can pay for the popcorn. So you start to, maybe in some relationships, this is where people start to head in towards the 50-50 stage, right? Right before the 50-50 stage. This is right after the spoiling stage, but right before the 50-50 stage, or right before the shared money stage, is the popcorn stage. Stage number three, the relationship starts to get a little deeper. You guys have been dating for a minute. We now call this a serious relationship. Okay, whether you're married or you're not married, it's now a serious relationship. You guys have been together for a while. I'm your boo, you are my boo thing, and everybody knows this, okay? This stage is called the need to know stage. You will know things on a need to know basis. How much is the rent for my crib? I will tell you if you need to know. How much does your car cost? I will tell you if you need to know. If your man is still taking you on vacations, it's like, I will tell you how much the vacation costs if you need to know. It's a need to know basis, and based on your man and his privacy settings on his life, he may let you know more things than usual, right? So you're more serious in a relationship. He may tell you a little bit about his salary if he feels like it's something you need to know. He may tell you how much groceries cost, electricity costs, how much things are starting to cost, how much the date cost, how much the shoes he bought for you cost, all of those things. If he feels like you need to know, you don't have the right yet, but the financial conversations are starting to happen and they're starting to flow, and only if he feels as though his privacy settings are set to a point where he's okay with you knowing these details, then he will tell you. Only on a need to know basis. Number four is the give and take stage. This is the stage where you can get stuck, right? It's a goodish stage. It's good, but it's not great, okay? The give and take stage is now where you guys have either moved in together, you are married, you know, that type of stage where he may pay for the house and you may pay for the groceries. He may give a little here and you may take a little here, okay? And you start to know, you know, my salary is 50,000, you know, give or take. The car's about 10,000, give or take. You get round numbers, okay? Estimations, plus minus. That's where we are in our relationship. There is a little bit more transparency. You feel like you know a lot about a person's finances because he earns about 100,000, give or take. His car is the value of about, you know, 7,000 a month, give or take. So you have a bracket, you have a ballpark figure of what is going on financially in his life. And you may also feel the same. And for many relationships, people can be married for years, honeys. They can die and be stuck on this give or take level. Because you feel like you know, but honey, do you though? And finally, number five, this is the stage where you actually want to be. This is where you dream of being. This is the best stage of them all. This is now where the relationship is so strong that honestly, there is absolutely nothing left. It's the naked stage. It's Adam and Eve before they ate the fruit. So, shilling, naked, commando, birthday suit. Where you are naked in front of each other financially. You see, even when you're naked with a person, you may not know that I have a beauty mark, a beauty spot on the inner thigh. But I'm naked still. You know my salary, you know how much my car costs, you know my debts, but there's small little secrets. Where my birthmark is, you may not know about the little tattoo that I hid on my inner thigh. You may not know about the scratch that I have here or there, but it's naked still. Majority of the being is in front of you, stark naked. And now you know, in good detail, what has been placed in front of you. The small things may not be completely transparent. You may not know exactly how much I'm sending to the church. You may not know exactly how much I'm spending on online shopping. You may not know exactly how much I'm spending on my clothes every single month. But you know in detail I'm naked in front of you. And if I really did want to show you my beauty mark on my arm, but I could just raise my hand and show you, there's no obstructions. And this is the level where we want to be in a relationship, where we can sit down and we both have our budgets open in front of each other and we are completely honest about what's going on. And we are completely honest about what's coming in and what's going out. There may be small little finer details that we're not looking at with a fine tooth comb, but nothing's been hidden from you. Nothing's been covered up from you. Small details, yes, you may not take the time to look for them, but they're not done on purpose. So you may still have your secret investment account as a woman that you've been putting away about 10% of your income into that space where your man has been thinking you've been shopping, you've actually been investing. You may still have, you know, your funds going in. You may be investing in some foreign currencies. You may be investing on the stock exchange. Small little things that you have done. You may have an additional life policy for your child's education that you've been paying very steadily, small amount, that your man might not know about in full detail, but you're still naked. Those are the small things, but he knows the big stuff. He knows the size of your boobies, that they sag a bit, that he knows your arms, your legs, your thighs, you know, that the bush is a bush, it's not really trimmed or shaved. But you're naked in front of each other. You're completely naked. And should he want to know, you can tell him. And should you want to know, he'll tell you. And this is the ultimate stage. Now, couples can get stuck in level 4, even when they are married. At a level where it's just like roundabout, give or take. But what we want is full transparency, where I know how much you're earning and I know how much we have at the end of the month. The smaller details, we'll let that slide. But can we be naked with each other in our relationship? All right, beautiful people, that is it. That is all I have for you today on this episode of How I Do Things. We're talking chalete, baby, on a Tuesday. So let me know, what stage are you at in your relationship and how do you want to maneuver around this one? Until next time, beautiful people, I'm Kopano Shimange and this is How I Do Things. Hey gorgeous, thank you so much for tuning in and thank you for making it right until the end. Now, if you have not subscribed to my channel, why? Why? Are you waiting so long? Click on this button right here to subscribe to my channel and feel free to binge watch. No judgment. Actually, I'm judging you if you have not binge watched. Okay? Head over to my website, www.kopanashimange.com, to find my new journal, Her Daily Success Journal, which is all about centering yourself on God, fulfilling your goals, and going to sleep with gratitude. Until next time, mwah, toodles.